नमः शिवाय नमो नारायण
ओम नमः शिवाय नमो नारायण
ओम नमः शिवाय नमो नारायण
ओम नमः शिवाय
With pranams at the lotus feet of our most beloved Bhagavan, dear brothers and sisters, let me first of all convey our grateful thanks to Bhagavan and a deep sense of appreciation to the artists of national reputation who presented wonderful Carnatic music program at Sai Kulwant Hall yesterday evening. God bless you, sir. I know fully well how Bhagwan loves Carnatic music. There is one place by name Venkatagiri of Nellore district in Andhra Pradesh. Venkatagiri Raja's Palace happened to be the residence for Bhagwan whenever he visits that place. And Swami used to stay there for a number of days, a number of times every year he used to visit that. And Venkatagiri is the place of Carnatic music. All artists, vocalists, instrumentalists from all over Tamil Nadu, they are invited to Venkatagiri. And they entertain Swami, make him happy, round the clock, 24 hours. At midnight, next singer will be there, that's all. But still it will be going on. Swami loves the music, Carnatic music, so much. And yesterday they did it exceedingly well. And we all felt divine presence and divine vibrations. May Bhagwan continue to inspire you forever and ever. And I also request the Tamil Nadu brothers, members of the organization, to plan such programs hereafter, more and more, because by doing that activity, which makes Swami very happy, pleasing unto him, we naturally receive his countless blessings. We are going to be blessed by that. Therefore, kindly organize such music programs, Carnatic music, more, more and more. I also remember one of the situations, Pattammal, when she was singing in front of Swami. Swami was so happy and blessed her. And she said, Swami, Tyagaraja sang to please Ramachandra. The same thing is repeated now. We are pleasing you, Swami, that's all, she said. Therefore, it's a matter of great pleasure to have that program yesterday. And the Tamil Nadu is known for the Carnatic music. The music has gone even to the villages also in the whole of Tamil Nadu. That we can certainly feel proud of the state. The second reason is the Indian culture, the spirituality, the tradition, 100% prevailing there in that state. And wherever they go, because as far as I remember, many of the countries I had been and this Tamil Nadu group have been maintaining the Indian culture, the Indian tradition 100%. We pray Baba to shower his choicest blessings on all of you and your families as well. Thank you very much. We have just one more Sunday. Thereafter, we are very close to Shivaratri. And this group comprises regular study circle group, Sunday group, and in addition to that, special guests from Tamil Nadu. Therefore, I prefer to make it general and also focused on this subject. This applies to all sorts of music. The music, be that Hindustani or Carnatic, be that bhajans, solo or group singing, whatever may be. This is the quotation, this is the statement of Baba. Come on, go on singing. You don't need to fear. You will never face any risk, any danger in your life because I am by your side. That's what Baba said. Therefore, the musicians, those that sing glory of Baba, those that sing music in the name of any god, Rama or Krishna, Durga, any deity, any bhajan, Baba assures us that we will be safe and secure. It is divine life insurance coverage. What more you want? So let us maintain that. The second statement. Somebody said, Swami, please bless us with opportunities, many more in the years to come, so that we will be coming to this place again and again and have your darshan. Then Baba said, please note this statement. I always collect the statements and explain and apply. That is the secret of Anil Kumar, that's all. Collection, explanation, application, that's all. I don't add any original and nothing, no interpretation. Swami gave us oceanic knowledge, fathomless depths of knowledge. Why should you add your own knowledge and pollute the golden original Sai literature? Let us not adulterate the original scripture, Sai literature. The second statement, see that. Swami, help me to come again and again to this place. What did he say? You should also determine to come here. You should also decide to come here. When you decide to come here, when you also determine to come here, I'll pull you to this place. That is a combination of human effort and the divine will that brought all of you here to Pranchi Prachantralayam. And he gives one example. Here is a dynamo. Here is a bulb. The bulb illumines because of the dynamo, correct? But you should switch it on. You have to put on the switch. Similarly, you are a devotee, correct? And my will, grace is always there, correct? But you should put on the switch of your effort so that the grace of electricity will flow automatically. Secondly, somebody said, Swami, why don't you do for yourself? Why don't you do for yourself? These answers, Swami, I tell you, all questions are answered in his divine discourses. But what we do is, we go into the samadhi state while listening to his discourses, meaning sleep. Therefore, those points don't get into our head. Or we'll be thinking of the next flight to leave the place or train reservation. That's why these points don't get into our heads. But if you analyze, you'll understand how cleverly Swami answered all questions, however smart we may be. Swami, why don't you do it for yourself? Then Swami says, Yemai atla japta undavu? Chuchinava? Tatta undadi. Tattalo chapati kurma petinaru. Mootiki plateki pyamamam petali kada. Yem atla japta undavu? What he says, here is a plate. And the plate has got all chapati and sabji, the kura, the combination. That is ready. Your mouth is ready to eat. But there should be some job given to the hand so that you can. That is human effort. That is human effort. Sir, I ask you this question straight away. Who can explain like that? Who can give such an example other than Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba, the Guru of Gurus of this age? Nobody else. Nobody else. You can take it from me. That is the thing. Third thing he said. Some people come and say, Swami, my husband is not devoted. Oh. Some man says, Swami, my wife is not as much a devotee as I am. As if there is some weighing machine to know the devotion or some thermometer to know the temperature of devotion. People say that. But the problem here is, wife says that husband is not very much devoted. Poor fellow is just watching the wife. Because of the pressure, that fellow also gradually becomes a devotee. Being a man, he gets deeply sunk into the organization and Swami activity. The same lady cries now, Swami, my husband is suffering too much from Sai Baba. Please help him to take out. Let him give some time to the family. So we complain against each other that they don't have belief. I have belief. I have extra belief. They don't have as much of weight of devotion as I have. Silly competition. This is the statement of Baba. Whether you believe me or not, whether you participate in bhajans or not, whether you sing my glory or not, whether you have seen me or not, all of you belong to me. Only Satya Sai Baba can say that. All of you belong to me. Nobody can run away from me. Nobody can escape me. You all belong to me. Swami, all belong to you. Yes, why not? Then he says, I'll give you a technique to feel me. We all belong to you. But how to feel you, Swami? We should feel. Yes. How to feel Swami? How to experience Swami? He has given secret here. Baba, when I am suffering like this, when I am in need of you, when I have my physical problems, financial problems, social problems, professional problems, don't you listen to my prayers, Swami? Are you not able to hear me? Are you on vacation or what? Where are you? Brava Bharama Gurra Ragurama Brava Bharama Bhuvanamellani. The whole universe belongs to you. But am I extra burden to you? What happened to you, Swami? When you say that, Baba says, he'll have both of his ears to hear you. I'll give both of my ears to hear you. When you shout, Swami, what happened to you? Are you not listening to my prayers? I am there to listen to you. Swami, don't you see my fate in the family? How long can I live in a tiled house? I should have some better house, he said. How long should I walk? I deserve a scooter at least. How long? How long can I rot like this? I need some promotion. What's all this? I spend so much of money for my daughter's marriage. Why can't I get some money through my son? Income tax balance. Don't you see my position now? Don't you understand my condition now? When you say that, Bhagavan says, he will have both of his eyes focused on you. When you cry, don't you hear me? Both of ears are there. When you say, don't you see me? Both of their eyes are focused. Swami, though many of my people started making fun of me, though many of people made a matter of joke that I am Baba's believer, everybody says, is Baba devotee? Baba, I became object of mockery, fun. But I surrendered to your feet, Swami. What happened to you? Where are they? I surrendered to your feet long back. Now Swami says, when you say that, both of my feet are there, you'll notice. Both of my feet are there. And then, Swami, I have nobody else to help me. I have nobody else to stand by me. When you say so, I protect you, I take care of you. Sarva dharman parichajya, mam ekam charanam vraja. Mam ekam charanam vraja. If you surrender to me alone, I take care of you. That's what Bhagavan said. The Sanskrit sloka of Bhagavad Gita is put in this style. I look at you, I hear you, my feet are with you, and you surrender to me, I take care of you. Ananyaschintayanto mam, ye janah paryupasate, yesham nichavitanam, yoga kshemam vahamyam. These are all the divine assurances which are put in a simple way. Because we are tired of scriptural Sanskrit rendition. Because the Sanskrit rendition is for quotation, if not for implementation. So it is not scholarship. Something to be handy, something to come to our support right now, anchor. So Swami puts it in a simplest way. Then, Swami, why don't you call me? How is it I'm away from you, Bhagavan? I used to visit this place every month. Slowly and slowly, I started visiting you once in 3 months. Slowly and slowly, once in 6 months. Now, Swami, a few years lapsed. I am not able to see you, Swami. Long back I had your darshan, Swami. Have you forgotten me? Shall I say that I don't enjoy your grace and mercy? Should I feel that I don't have your blessings, Bhagavan? Why am I not frequenting this place? Why am I losing my faith? Why? Why am I doubting you? Why am I not as strong, as firm in my faith till now? Why is it being shaken today? What, Swami? When we say that, he gives you the reply. Say that. Do I ever deny you? Do I ever reject you? Can I say no to you? You are my child. No mother would say no to his child, however bad the child is. No father would disown the son, however bad he is. I am the divine parent, Mata Pita, Guru Daivam Mariyantai Nile. The divine father, the divine mother cannot say no to you, will never say no to you. We'll never deny you. Why do you think like that? Oh, Swami, then why am I thinking like this? Why? Tell me. Why am I thinking that you are not merciful unto me? Why am I thinking that you are not kind enough towards me as before? That is my question. And Swami comes back with an answer. Look here, you are traveling in a train. You catch a train, railway train. You travel by that train. When the train is speeding ahead, you find trees are running, mountains are running. Are they running? Who is running? Train is running, not you. And the trees are not running. Train is running, that's all. So you, the man, train, the mind, is running, but I am steady like a tree and a mountain. You are running, think I am running. What a wonderful example. He gave another example also. When we go to Bangalore or Chennai, we say Chennai is coming. And from Chennai when you come here, Chennai left. Chennai has not come, Chennai has not left. You have gone, you left, that's all. So I am where I am, Ra. You come and go, you think I am leaving you. So correct your mind. Then you will understand, I continue to love you forever, forever and ever. He gives another example. My friends, I tell you, there is an emergent need today to spread His message more and more and more to all corners of the world, so that the world will know that Sai Baba is a world teacher. Sai Baba is an avatar, plus He is a world teacher. That also we should spread His message far and wide in all nooks and corners of the world. See, beautiful, simple example. This is all Swami's, I tell you once again. Nothing is Anil Kumar's own. Now, here is a well. And you draw water through a pulley there. See, the agricultural areas, in India we have wells. And we draw water out of the well, out of the pulley. And we have bucket there. What do? You let the bucket go into the well. Then what do you see? You will watch whether the bucket is full of water or not. When it is full, then you draw out the water. Now what are you doing? You allow the bucket and pull it out without the water being full there. You don't look in whether the water has been filled or not. You just draw out the bucket. It's your mistake. Water is there. You don't look in. Number two, you draw, while drawing, you leave the bucket in the middle. It goes back. Where is water? It's gone. Therefore, your bucket is the mind. I am the water. The well is life. In this well of life, you allow the bucket to get into the well of life and fill it with water of divinity and pull it out, self-effort or sadhana. The process of getting it out is sadhana or spiritual practice. But what you do? You don't do sadhana, pull it out, finish, empty basket. Empty. Or what you do? You don't notice whether the bucket is full of water or not. We don't wait until we are perfect in our sadhana. So it's your fault. Water is there in the well throughout. Swami's divinity is throughout there in life. Everywhere. We don't have to search about it. That's why Swami gave this beautiful example. And he gives another example. I tell you, my friends, in the whole of Sanskrit literature, it is Kalidasa. Kalidasa, who is known for examples, illustrations. Upama Kalidasa, Kalidasasya, not Upma, Upama. Upma is there in South Indian canton. I mean Upama. Upama meaning here similes, illustrations, examples. Upama Alankara, Utpreksha Alankara, these are all figures of speech. Simile, metaphor, irony, synecdoche, these are all different figures of speech. Simile. In the whole of Sanskrit literature, Kalidasa is known for similes or upamalankara. Then among the gurus, Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa is known for upamalankara similes. And among avatars, Jesus Christ is known for these similes or upama alankara. Today, Bhagavan Sri Satsai Baba is the only one whose discourses are punctuated by full of illustrations, full of examples, such that we will understand the philosophy, deeply, easily. Swami's philosophy is so simple. We have got our elder brother from Kodaikanal, he is here also. In Kodaikanal we have a usual regular conversation. Swami talks to you like a friend. He doesn't expect you to say, you are Narayana, you are Parabrahma, so what? I am Parabrahma, you don't need to declare. I am Narayana, you don't need to give me identification, certificate, ID card, not necessary. So there in Kodaikanal, he gives you that freedom to talk to him freely. Like a friend you can talk to him. Go ahead. This is the statement made. Swami, spirituality is so difficult, what shall we do? It is so tough. You know what Baba said? No, 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 it is very easy. Swami, is it easy? Yes. He took the flower there, a rose flower. See how soft it is? Spirituality is like that. Softer than butter, lighter than cotton. So light as the rose flower, that is spirituality. Then the question is, how do we find it difficult? When you say easy, why do I find it difficult? You prefer difficulty. You prefer difficulty. You choose toughness. You want complications. Swami, simple ra, meeru ample em chesedi. You make a mountain out of the mole, I make the mole out of the mountain. Simplification is Satya Sai Baba, complication is Guru. If anyone complicates, he is Guru, thank you. If anyone simplifies, Satya Sai Baba. Is it my observation? Is it my too much of expression? No. It was Howard Murphett. Howard Murphett from Australia. He said, one thing to know that he is a guru, one thing to know that he is divine, only one secret, he said. Huh? What is it? Ability, capacity to communicate most complicated things in the simplest way ever possible. That is true with Bhagwan Sri Satsai Baba. Very much true. He simplifies such that we'll be able to understand. Somebody said, Swami, I kept some naivedyam. Naivedyam is offering. People keep some cooked rice or whatever there for the morning. Offer to God. Just as we say prayers before dining, people make offering, naivedya. When one lady offered some naivedya, it seems a dog came and ate away the whole stuff. Next day when she offered milk, some cat came there and took it. This lady is very much annoyed with cats and dogs of Puttaparthi. This happened in Puttaparthi. Of course, now we should add third population also, monkeys. The third tribe also increasing in large number. Of course. Now, this lady from Puttaparthi said, Swami, dogs and cats are bothering us like anything. What shall I do? You know what Baba said? It is not my business to drive them out. It's not my business. My business is to see whom you are hurting by your words and deeds. How you are hurting the feelings of others. How you are damaging the feelings of others. How you are hurting others. That I am watching. I am not yet to watch your cats and dogs. What does it mean indirectly? Indirectly it meant some of us here, if not all of us, with due apology to exceptions, are very capable of hurting others. Very capable. Easily. Sir, can I sit there? No! Oh. Can I have an extra spoon of sambar? Oh, no. Sir, I'm going by train this evening. Can I just go? This is style. This is the style. You ask anybody. Yes, you don't get from anybody. So this is the stuff with which Baba has been managing, because he is God. Well, you don't need any other proof that he is managing all of us with a negative mind. Now Baba says this, how nicely he said. I'm watching everybody, how you are hurting, how you are dispiriting people. They come here with spirits and you just demoralize them, dispirit them. That hurts me more than your dogs and cats. That's what he said. Then, in those days, people thought Baba is a magician. Of course, in those, even now, some stupids think like that. We can't help them. We can't help them. I don't need to blame Dhritarashtra for not able to see me. He is born blind. How can I help him? So they are born stupids also. We can't help them. We can only pray for them so that they learn some good sense to prevail as the time passes by. Somebody thought that Swami kept something there in the sands of Chitravati. So he will take them there. Now I'll get you apple. Take it. Which he kept already. This is how our human mind works. But the divine mind knows all this. The divine mind knows all this, cosmic mind. He understood what we are thinking. He sat at one place. All right, come here. You go anywhere. All over Chitravati road, all over Chitravati river bed, you go anywhere. Just desire any fruit you want, or any art, any gift you want, pick up the sand, you will get there. All people went, one fellow got a chain, one fellow got a ring, one fellow got apple, other got guava, whatever they wanted, they got it. They all came and fell at his feet. Hari Om Swami, sorry. We are sorry, we are mistaken. Then Baba said, because you doubted, it is my duty to see that you don't doubt anymore. My duty is therefore I ask you to spread and go everywhere. Then Swami made this statement. This one should remember. Whatever I think, whatever I will, it will happen. That's all. The thought or the will is sankalpa. That sankalpa, the thought or the will, fruition or fulfillment or fructification or manifestation of his thought into a reality is siddha. His thought gets into the reality. If he says you are going to be an engineer, yes, you will be an engineer. That's all. Even if you want to be a doctor, you cannot. Even if you become a doctor, you will study biological engineering there. You are a biologist, but biological engineering, you will become a doctor. Because his will happen. Sankalpa siddha. Sankalpa, the thought of the will, is sure to happen, is sure to be a reality in due course of time. Once he brought an apple fruit. There are 50 people there. He made it into 4 pieces. Believe me or not, I'll give the addresses of the people also, including door numbers if you want. All the 50 got 1/4 of the fruit, same quantity, all the 50 people out of one fruit. That is such a Sai Baba. People said, Swami, how could you do it? People want to know, perhaps they too want to do it. Natural, why can't I be such Sai Baba? When you say you are God, yes, I am also such, let me do it. It's not possible. Yes, 1,000 candles, total divinity. And we have 0 candles, sometimes filament off. What is it you and I can do? Impossible. Then Baba said, Swami, you cut the fruit into 4 bits. And each one got 1/4 of the fruit, 50 people. How is it possible? He said, when I could create an apple, can't I create 1/4 to you? When I could create the whole fruit, is it a problem to create 1/4? No. That's what he explains in a simple way. All right, Bhagavan, we are here for a pretty long period. We enjoyed your company. We heard your discourses. We had number of darshans, but, it is so sad to leave you. It is so sad to leave you. It is very unfortunate to leave you. Though I am happy smiling all these days, at this moment when I have to leave you, I cry, I do not know. On seeing you, I cried tears of joy. As I leave you, I cry the tears of grief. Because of separation, I am going, leaving, Swami. I feel like crying. What do you say about it? Please follow me. How Baba is so human, totally divine, totally human, complete 100% divinity, 100% humanity is equal to such a Sai Baba. Please understand, both are in perfect combination. So when somebody said, Swami, we are leaving, we feel so sad, feel like crying, then Baba said this, how touching it is. Follow it carefully. You are luckier than me. Why? You go home and you are busy with your business, you are busy with your families, you are busy with all your avocations and professions, and you forget me. But where am I? I have nobody else. I think of you only. I think of you only. I have nobody else. I have no other relatives, no other job, no profession. My only job is only to take care of you. My only job is only to think of you. I am alone, Ra. You are better because you can forget me and I cannot do that. Then one lady, Swami, I am leaving this place, Swami. I run business there. I got number of shops there in Bangalore and Chennai. I must manage my business. I must go, Swami. I am going. No, see, can't you stay for 2 days more? Please, please. She stayed for 2 days more. Then Swami said, no, why can't you stay a little bit? And this lady, business. And finally she said, Swami, what am I after all? Even if I go, there are so many devotees there. You can be happy with them. Then Baba said, there are so many devotees, correct? ఆ షెడ్లోకి వెళ్ళి చూడు, ఎంత గోళ, ఎంత గలాట, ఒకరొకరు నేరీతిగా పోట్లాడుకుంటా ఉండారప్ప. అబ్బా అబ్బా, ఎందుకు నాకు ఈ గ్యాంగి, వాళ్ళతోటే గడపాలయ్యా నేను. బాబా సేస్, వెన్ యూ పీపుల్ కమ్ అండ్ గో, ఐ హావ్ టు స్పెండ్ విత్ దిస్ లోకల్ స్టఫ్ హియర్ అండ్ యూ గో టు ఎనీ షెడ్ అండ్ లిసన్ టు వండర్ఫుల్ ఫైటింగ్ గోయింగ్. How each one shouts at other person. No love at all. have to spend my time with them. So I want you to stay here for some more time, says helpless Baba. And then Swami says another point. There are some people who say that now that Baba is not there, he is not here, so he is at your place. There are some people say he is not there. He is with us, I see. The one who is not there, who is with you, cannot be God. Impossible. He should be everywhere. But this is a kshetra. I gave this example long ago. Lord Venkateswara is everywhere, but Tirupati is Tirupati. Tirupati is Kshetravasi. Venkateswara is Kshetravasi. He dwells there. But at the same time, his power is everywhere. Something like generator that supplies current all over. Baba's example. He attended one very big function there in Bangalore. It went off very well. Grand function. And Swami was happy. While moving among the devotees, he said, "You seem to have forgotten Puttaparthi. You seem to have forgotten Puttaparthi." Then they said, "Swami, since you are here, how can I forget that?" Then Baba said, "You come to Puttaparthi, stay there for some time. Enjoy that divinity. Enjoy those vibrations. You come there. Why do you want to push each other and come for my darshan? At thickly crowded places like this, why can't you come?" This statement says that this is the kshetra that is here, very much everywhere. At the same time, this is the center, which we should visit as many times as possible till the end of our life. This is my appeal to you. I can also tell you another point he said, the divine technology. We heard of B.Tech, Bachelor of Technology. We heard of M.Tech, Master of Technology. Bhagavan Sri Satchai Baba has a degree, D.Tech, Divine Technology. But he is only a holder, that's all. Nobody can get enrolled under D.Tech program. Divine technology. What does it mean? Wonderful statement he said. Sometimes we feel, how is that egoistic fellow is here? How is such an arrogant fellow is here? How is that a discourteous man is here? How is that man who after power is like this? Why? How is that I don't find any love in him? How is that I don't find any smile on the face? Why? Sometimes we feel like that. Because some people arrogate themselves. Supposing if Swami says, "You are in charge of this carpet." That in charge of carpet will make you feel more than IFS, Indian Foreign Service. Carpet in charge. Enna pandrathu sir indha madri? What is stupid with such type of paichikar madri? With such stuff, what is to be done? So anything will get into our head and feel very special. Very special. You be here, send people one after one. Oh, but then he becomes very powerful, emperor and all that. Swami, what is all this? What is all this? Why is it happening? Baba's answer is this. My technique is this. I allow the fellow to be egoistic, more egoistic, all egoistic, totally egoistic. Then bring him to my feet later, next state. Meaning, pump the air into the balloon more and more, more, pat, then it will come down. Therefore, whoever you come across, with ego, pride, position, consciousness, is like a balloon full of ego, which may any time. And he gives another example. When football is full of air, what do? You go on kicking with your feet, that side, this side. Goal. When the football air is taken out of that football, deflated, meaning take out the air out of the football, then what will happen? Football which is full now becomes a chapati. What have you to do now? You cannot kick it. You have to lift with your both of your hands. So you, the football, with air, the ego, will be kicked by people that side, this side. When once the ego is gone, people lift with both your hands and do namaskar. That is the example of Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba. See that, sir. We can spend time like this thinking of his beautiful message. Any number of hours, any number of sessions, any number of days are not adequate to speak about his message and to recall the divine experiences we have in the life of every individual. Let me not name the person. One person said recently, Mr. Anil Kumar, you are writing the names of so many people. Don't write everybody's name. Write down the names of those people of the rank of a district president, not other people. I said, you are hopeless fellow on earth. All are devotees not because of district presidents. They are devotees in spite of district presidents. In spite of them. Don't say that district president should come there. No. A field in which there is no cadre, a field in which there is no level, a field in which there is no color, gender, time, space, a field which is common, uniform, equal, that is Satya Sai Baba, divinity, understand that. Let us not build some ranks and files and spoil our minds. We should not do that. Therefore, what does Baba say? Arre, wonderful statement. Dehamu prapanchanikaya, manasu madhavuniki. The mind towards God. Manasu madhavuniki. Your mind for Madhava, God. Dehamu prapanchaniki. Body to the world. Meaning the body has got to be used in service to the society. Mind for meditation on him. Previously in English he said, hands in society, head in the forest. Who will tell like that? But the fellow who doesn't understand, head in the forest means let me cut my head and put it there. Udumalai forest, hands inside, two hands cut off, put it near the bus stand. So, moksha. She fool. Forest meaning renunciation. Forest meaning detachment. Forest meaning wisdom. Forest meaning meditation. To quote Baba, forest for rest. That is Satya Sai Baba. We are not fools to run after him. Please understand. The fools who think that we are fools are really double fools. For rest is forest. So mind should be at rest in meditation. Mind should be at rest in contemplation. Mind should be at rest in singing his glory. Mind, head in the forest. Hands in society. Not that anatomy theater to be cut into pieces, thrown there. No. Service to the community. So, manasu madhavuniki, mind is for Madhava, God. Dehamu prapanchaniki, body for the world. That's what Swami said. Long back, somebody said, Swami, You are coming to Bangalore, we heard. On the way, there is my house.
Why didn't you come?
Very simple. Swami said, I will come. But there are many, many people that follow me. How do you accommodate them? It's a small house. We think Baba visits the houses of rich people. We are wrong. Even if he comes, we cannot accommodate all the people that follow him. There will be at least 30 to 40 people. 100 cars. What are we going to do? We don't have enough of food for the members of the family. How do you entertain the royal guest? Rajadhiraja Ramachandra Jagadvandana. The king of kings, Bhagavan. Is it easy to entertain him? It's not that easy. So Swami says, yours is a small house, but I will come. For me, you and I are same. For me, it's nothing. I will certainly come. But how about my gang? There are so many people, what shall I do? Then this lady is a clever lady, very clever. Swami, don't worry about it. I shall see that nobody will know that you are coming to our house. Nobody will know. Let it be black market, underground CPM affair. So that nobody can know. I will take care of that. Then Baba laughed and said, look here. Arare, you seem to be very innocent. And he gives example there. When you are carrying a basket of jasmine flowers, you don't need to say that there are flowers. Flowers need not come and say, hey, we are flowers, come here, come. They don't need. The smell is enough, people will come there. Similarly, when Swami visits, the fragrance of Sai is spread everywhere. Everywhere will come, people will come to know that and they'll come there. You cannot hide it. Long back, it happened another situation. A lady happened to follow a guru. A guru gave some mantra. She is also another very famous guru, that other lady. And she used to go to her and receive upadesha, mantra to repeat. One day that lady said, you don't need to come hereafter. What is it? Have I done any harm to you? Have I done any disservice to you? Have I disobeyed you any time? Please, Guru, why are you so angry with me? Then that Guruji tells her, I am not angry with you. I am giving you promotion. Promotion? What promotion? Because you are following my teaching upadesha, I want to tell you one thing. What is it? A flower is born. That flower is blossoming. In Puttaparthi, you go there, directed the Guru. You go there. That flower there is blossoming. I'm giving you promotion. Better you go there. All Asia has come. Oh, enjoyed Swami's presence. And Swami gives interview. Very happy. And then this lady said, Swami, what mantra should I repeat? See, Swami, all-knowing, immediately said, you received mantra from your previous guru. You repeat that, that is enough. You repeat that, that's enough. This is something great of Sat Sai Baba. He will never ask you to forsake your gurus. He will never ask you to give up upadesha you receive from any noble soul or a saint. He'll never give you something, a new prescription, a new formula. No. Hold on to the formula. Hold on to the mantra that is taught to you, says Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba. Then somebody said, Swami, I did not receive upadesha from anybody. I have not started any sadhana till now. You tell me, I will start from today. Oho, very good determination. Swami said, not now.
Why not now, Swami? Why not?
I say I am fresh. No Upadesha till now. I have not gone to any guru till now. Fresh. Tell me, whatever you do, I do it.
Then Swami says, you have got family responsibilities. You have got some family problems. You are doing a job. You have got some professional problems. Because of that, you lose your temper now and then. Where there is a temper, where there is anger, note this point. Where there is a temper, where there is anger, you will not have the fruits of meditation. You will not enjoy the fruits of meditation, the fruits of penance, no. So long there is a temper and anger. First to cool down. Then I'll tell you to do something later. This is a lesson to all of us. Sometimes we feel, why? I'm doing all this. Why not I get the result? Why not? I've been meditating, yes. Every day I meditate. Ask my neighbors. They'll tell you. You want a witness also. You ask my wife whether I'm meditating or not. She'll certainly say, because that's only period when you are silent. And she also wishes that you should extend your meditation so that silence will prevail some more, that you don't bother the family. Then yet we feel, why am I not getting results? Then Swami says, you are not getting the results because of the temper, of the anger in you. So long there are elements of anger and jealousy within you, you will not get the fruits of penance and meditation. That's what Bhagwan Baba has said. We are coming close to Shivaratri. I can't but make a reference. You know, in the year 1954, the old Mandir was built. 1954. Old Mandir in the village. When the foundation stone was laid by Bhagwan, when all the workers are digging, making preparation for foundation, there happened to be one worker there. One casual labor. That fellow's name is Venkanna. When he was digging with a crowbar, he saw Panavatta. I think all of us know what Panavattam is. The upward part is Sivalingam. Upward part. The lower platform is Panavattam. The lower platform is Panavattam. The upper projecting part is Sivalingam. So this man, Venkanna, as he was digging all over, he saw only horizontal parts, Panavattam everywhere. So many. He came to Swami, Swami, only Panavattam I noticed, horizontal part. How about Lingam? Naturally, when you find only one slipper, you will be worried of the other slipper. The latest technique followed by devotees is this. One slipper in North Pole, other in the South Pole. This management technique. So you know what Baba said? You found all Panavattams there, the horizontal part. You are asking me, what about Lingam? They are there in my stomach now, he said. That fellow did not understand what Baba meant. The Sivalingam, emergence of Sivalingam, Lingodbhava, at the time of Shivaratri, are Sivalingas in his stomach. That whole universe is in him. The entire Sivalingam, it's all its majesty, grandeur, resplendence, with all its radiation, is within him, which emerges as Sivalingam and Lingodbhava. That's what Bhagavan said long back. And I can also tell you what Swami also said. Somebody said, Swami, I am fed up with my family. I want to leave them and I want to be here. Spirituality is not avoidance. Spirituality is not avoidance. Spirituality is not escapism. When these ladies say, I want to go, keep quiet. Then Baba said, Draupadi served 5 husbands. Can't you serve 1 husband? Why do you find it difficult? And Krishna taught Arjuna to fight. At the same time, think of him. In war, also you should think of him. So God's message is, be you are in the world. Be in the world, but not of the world. You be in the world, but not of the world. And he gives a number of examples, like a boat on the surface of water. It floats. It is in water, but water is not in the boat. Boat is on the water, and water is not in the boat. Similarly, there are some people, Anil Kumar sir, you don't know, he's such a great man, he left his family. I doubt pinch of salt there. He left his family because family might have asked him to get out because of irresponsibility. Or he must have made so many loans which he cannot pay back, therefore. Because we find newspapers all such cases. Leaving the family is not religion. Leaving the responsibility is not religion. It is only Satya Sai Baba who combines, who mixes, who joins, who connects both the aspects, both the sides of the coin, the world and God being one and the same. That is Satya Sai Baba. That's why in Sai Mission we have no sannyasis. There may be sannyasis, hopeless fellows. Sannyasi is different from sannyasi. Sannyasi is a hopeless fellow. So we have no sannyasi, celibates. Because you be ready to face the world. You should equip yourself to face the world. You have got all your responsibilities and family ties. Yet you should be in a position to think of him. That is spirituality. That is the purpose of this incarnation, which is very, very novel. And now Swami says, look here, Amma, please look. Swami tells her, you married your husband with fire as the witness. Fire is the witness, Agni Sakshi. With fire as a witness, Agni Sakshi, you married that man. So you should serve your pati, husband. At the same time, you'll earn Atmapati, the husband of yourself, Bhagavan himself. Therefore, Swami says, serve your pati, husband. That takes you to Atmapati, the Lord of the Spirit, the Divine Consciousness. I'll be pleased if your husband is pleased with you. I'm happy if your children are happy with you. That's what Bhagavan says there. Therefore, I can also tell another point. Somebody, a family came, and most of us, you know, we come with return tickets also. Most of my Hyderabad friends, they come in the morning, want to go by the evening. In between, Swami should give them a ring and a chain and interview, a vibhuti and amurgam, if possible, liberation also. Package deal. Wholesale business. Nothing doing. Swami will keep that fellow wait until he loses the money for the return ticket. You cannot give appointment to Swami. Swami should give appointment to you. Therefore, a family says, Swami, we want to go.
stay here. Swami, where to go? Swami, I got some business there, I must go. I know, be here. Next day, Swami, I should go there. You have no business here. You don't know business, loss and gain. Your business is only devotees. So Swami, please, we know what business is. You know. Then Baba tells them, you are thinking of money always. You are like, and Swami is angry. He'll go to any extent. You are money-minded, your mother is grandmother is money-minded, grandfather is money-minded, your clan is money-minded, the whole family is money-minded, the whole Madras is money-minded. He will say the whole place, because when he is like that, someone is happy with you, you are a very good devotee, because your mother is a great devotee, your grandmother is embodiment of devotion, you are from Madras, the land of culture and tradition, therefore you are like that. Because Swami's car has two gears, front gear and reverse gear. He can go backwards also. Then he says, always money is your constant thinking. You say, want to go home, go home. No. And when I am here, why do you worry of money? When you stand by the side of a river, why do you want cool drinks from elsewhere? Why do you ask somebody to give you a glass of water? You are by the side of the river. You are by the side of Sri Mahalakshmi, Bhagwan Baba. I can give you as much as you want. I know. Why are you worried it? Then out of disgust he said it. This is the statement we should remember. If you want money and family, get out. If you want me and God, stay here. If you want me and God, be here. If you want money and family, you are welcome to go. This only Baba could say that. Therefore, my friends, we are all here. Because of this attachment to Swami, because of this divine bliss that we draw from Him, because of the comfort we have, because of the divine benediction that we enjoy throughout. With the last point I would add, in this context, what did he say? Swami is always for construction. You must have seen. Some construction or other goes on, forever and ever in Puttaparthi. If you come this month, some building will be coming up. Next month, some building there. Next month, this is gone, removed. Always destruction, construction, destruction, construction. Maybe to engage local people to pay them, maybe. Why should you construct and destroy it? That's what Swami does it. Somebody said, Swami, kattadam enti, kottadam enti, and Swami, what is all this? Kattadam, construction. Kottadam, demolition. Why this construction and demolition? Kattadam, kottadam, why? Swami said, kattadam, kottadam, construction, demolition is my job. Nee jabu, puttatam, gettatam, puttatam, gettatam. Puttatam birth, gettatam death. Birth and death is your job. Construction, destruction, my job, he said. About Shivaratri, my friends, Swami said beautifully a very important point. The mic is here. I am talking. You are able to hear me. This hearing is possible because of combination of two. The instrument mic here and the power supply. Without power supply, instrument is useless. Body, life inside. When there is no life, the body will have a place somewhere else. Am I clear? So, two things operate. Swami said that the body or the mic or the matter, which is inert, passive matter, Baba calls it as jada. Jada is matter, lifeless, passive, inert.
inactive matter, like jada. In this body, the jada, the inert, there is life there. Life there, chaitanya. Chaitanya meaning divinity, the awareness, the life, the power supply. Therefore, and the combination of two. One, the body. Number two, the life there. Now Swami says, body is jada, life is chit. These together make me functional. This combination is called sangama. Sangama meaning union, sangama. Because of this union, I, the individual, is here. Anga, the body. Anga, the personality. This anga, the hand, is functional. Why? Because of life there. If there is no life, it is paralysis. Clear? Therefore, life and this sangha combination made this anga, the body. Am I clear, sir? Now, with this anga, what happens? We move in the world, identify ourselves with the world, be one with the world, and become worldly. That's called janga. Total identification with the world is jangama. So, sangha, anga, and janga. To come out of this janga, the worldliness, the only refuge is to surrender to linga. Sangamuloni, angamu, angamuloni, jangam tattvamu, jangamuloni yokka linga tattvamunu gurtinchi, ee prapanchika chintanu adhigaminchi, atma tattvamunu gurtinchute Shivaratri yokka sandeshamu. That's what Baba says. This is the combination of Shivaratri. And further he says, the panavattamu, the horizontal part, is prakriti, the world, the matter. The linga is the spirit, our conscience, our consciousness. Therefore, the body here, horizontal, we have to fall flat someday. But the spirit consciousness is urdhva, upward. So consciousness is urdhva, upward in its thought, which is universal. That is the meaning of panavatta, the material, and the linga, the spiritual, is Sivalinga, the cosmic Bhagavan. And further he says, linga meaning a sign. Liyate gamyam iti lingam. Lingam is only a sign, something like our national flag. National flag is a piece of cloth, but it's not the nation. But national flag is a sign of the nation. Am I not right? Currency note, paper only, but it's currency. Similarly, lingam is a sign of the divinity. Divinity embodied in the form of lingam. The second meaning of lingam is whole universe emerged out of it. Whole universe get merged in. Emergence, merger. How? From the ocean, rivers are born. Rivers originate. Rivers flow and flow and get back into the ocean. So ocean is Sivalingam. Rivers, all of us, flow and flow, get back into the ocean, God. That's what Baba says. You are from God, in God, to God. That is Sivalingam, Shivaratri. That's what Bhagavan explains. See that, who can explain like that? And if you pray to Shiva, you will not have desire. Why? I have so many desires. Therefore, I am miserable. I am miserable because of desires. When I have no desires, I can be happy. So, by thinking of Shiva, who is desireless, you can be desireless. By being desireless, we can be blissful, permanently happy. Therefore, Shiva is called Kama Hari. Kama, desire. Hare, desirelessness. So, oh Shiva Kama Hari, meaning you are desireless, make me desireless. Who will tell you like that? And then he says, Shiva is, makes you desireless. And now Swami explains, it is the desire that makes you born again. The cause for birth and rebirth is desire. A fellow like me has so many desires, including hot coffee and pickles. So I have no right to speak on liberation, forget about it. I am just repeating what Baba said. So, it is the desire that causes for birth and rebirth. Now, when you are desireless, you will be birthless. When you are birthless, you are deathless. Where there is birth, there is death. Birthless naturally leads to deathlessness. Mrityunjaya. Mrityunjaya. You don't have to be born again, deathless. So, Kamahari, O Shiva, you have no desire and you make me desireless. O Shiva, you are Mrityunjaya, therefore let me be deathless, meaning eternal, meaning immortal. See that, how nicely Shiva Namas have been explained by him. And Shiva is also called Digambara. Digambara, in the ordinary sense, the one who is nude or naked. Do you mean he has no suits to wear? Raman suit can't he afford Raman suits. Why that nudity? Why? That is the meaning we know. Why should you come to Baba to know the same meaning? Anyam etvat pashubir naranam. It's common features. Biological species. We share with the animal world the food, sleep, procreation, fear. These are the feelings that we have with the animal world. But when you think of God, you'll be above the animal instincts. If you are above the animal instincts, you are called Pashupati. This is the name of Lord Shiva, Pashupati. Meaning, by thinking of him, you'll rise above the animal instincts. There are many more things to learn. Next week, same day, same time. Thank you for being here. Om samasta loka sukhino bhavantu. Samasta loka sukhino bhavantu. Samasta loka sukhino bhavantu. Om shanti shanti. Jai bolo Bhagwan Sri Satsai Baba Ji ki. Jai bolo Bhagwan Sri Satsai Baba Ji ki. Jai bolo Bhagwan Sri Satsai Baba Ji ki.
Om Namah Shivaya Namo Narayana.
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 Om Namah Shivaya Namo Narayana. Namah Shivaya Namo Narayana.
Om Namah Shivaya Namo Narayana.
Om Namah Shivaya Namo Narayana.